And welcome back, everyone. We're going to be playing some more Wizard 101. Make sure you hit the like button. Make sure you subscribe button. Let's get into it.
Access to the ground. You must go and repair it now with the pieces you recovered. It should be easy to do.
You replace the missing pieces of the broken portal.
Job. No pun intended. I hate to send you packing when you just got here, but those are needed to open the Stellarium. Go and speak to Thornton Lewis in the District of the Stars. He'll be ever so grateful to see you.
Oh dear, who are you? You must be barking mad to come down here. It's a madhouse down here, to be certain. It's the sharks that are causing most of the trouble. They call themselves the Piscean Guard, and they claim to serve the Crustacean Empire. They've prevented us from our main work, surveying the region and learning what we can about Celestian culture. I assume you're here to rescue us and to learn about the Celestian schools of magic. If you want to rediscover the secrets of Celestian magic, then you must become one of us. First lesson, observation. Based on where it stands, that broken monolith is undoubtedly the key to entering the area beyond. Would you be so kind as to go and survey that monolith and return here with your findings?
The monolith is ancient, but upon closer examination, the broken edges look fairly fresh.
How interesting! A great deal of what explorers do is collect pieces of rubble. You see, the Celestians were very big on building secrets. You can read a lot about a culture. That said, they are crude vandals, always sometimes being an explorer. Could you go and recover some of the pieces of the broken monolith from the Piscean Guard?
Thank you.
Great work! I think you got all the missing pieces. Lesson 2. Restoration, or rebuilding that which was broken. We'll first need something to fuse the pieces together. The stellar protectors were made by the Celestians, and they're still... They're just suits of metal animated by power. The power motes should provide enough energy to fuse the pieces. Could you go and collect a few power motes from inactive stellar protectors? Though our mission is it makes sense to me. Can you defeat a number? That should cause them to rethink.
I am ready to teach you new abilities to enhance your prowess in magical duels. Speak to me when...
Those should do the trick. These power motes must be treated with extreme... Where will we...
You treat the power motes within the Starforge. In short order, they're ready for use.
Those should do perfectly. I've reassembled the pieces of the broken... Could you do us both a favor and go into the Astral Archive? Speak to the archivist there. It's sort of a talking library catalog that will tell...
I am the Archivist, a construct to aid research in the Astral Archive. Based on the nature of your request, I have prepared courses of instruction at 3 different preceptor stations. The stations are devoted to contrivances, conflict, and configurations. You may utilize them in any order you wish. Though the people of Celestia exist in harmony with the universe, the other worlds of the Spiral are not so. Celestia's magic touches the very Spiral. To mount a proper defense, Celestia must understand conflict.
The Preceptor has a great deal to say about all manner of conflict, from wars to magic duels. Eventually, the lesson ends.
Among the greatest of Celestia's achievements is the creation of magic artifacts. These contrivances are essential to Celestian life.
This goes on for a while. All manner of schematics, plans, and diagrams flash before your eyes until at last the lesson ends.
Celestia's greatest achievement is its mastery of astral magic. Celestian magic is intrinsically tied to...
The lesson continues for quite a while. So much to learn, and then the lesson ends.
Thank you.
excellent work. I'm sure they'll think twice before meddling. You look like you've been hitting the books. Did you learn it? Now that you've a working knowledge of Celestian, we can determine how the broken monolith relates to the surroundings. Understanding context is vitally important. We must know not only how something works, but what it means. The broken monolith has many markings. Could you go and survey the chantry to see what might be learned of the area? Return here with what you've learned.
You examine the observatory, using the powers of observation Mr. Lewis taught you. The mosaic on the floor appears important, based on the mosaic is clear. Unfortunately, it looks like many of the mosaic plates are missing. If they were there, the meaning would be clear.
So, what did you learn? You say someone stole the shiniest and brightest plates of the mosaic? Given what we know about the sharks, they're likely the culprit. I think you know what to do. Go and thrash some of those. Be sure to look around the rest of the chantry as well. So, you're a wizard, eh? Could you take this paper and stylus and go into the chantry and copy the chart of the... Thank you.
you find a small mosaic tile wedged into the gears of the orrery. A shark must have used this place to hide a small cache of mosaic tiles, perhaps to barter with. You take them.
Six, seven, eight, nine! You've recovered all the missing mosaic pieces. Smashing! Now you're ready to restore the mosaic floor to its former state. Head on into the chantry and see about putting the pieces back where they belong. That should put us ahead of the game. Excellent work! You're the best student I've ever taught. You've done much to earn your way into the Stellarium, but you're not done. I've taught you all I can, and the next steps are yours alone. Go to the Astral Archive and see if you can cadge some more out of that archivist. That should set you on the right path.
I am the Archivist, a construct to aid research in the Astral Archive. I am the Archivist, a construct created to aid research in... My empathic array detects that you are here searching for a means of entry into the Stellarium. Only Celestian citizens are permitted unrestricted access to the Stellarium. Temporary access to the Stellarium may be granted by allowing an empathic scan to determine suitability. Please present yourself to the preceptors of configuration, conflict, and contrivance. For once finished, return with the tokens denoting successful completion and place them in the security plinth. The preceptors have been activated and are ready for your use.
Preceptor lectures for a little while about identifying and resolving disagreements. When the lecture is complete, The preceptor produces a small metal token for you. Congratulations. There is an extremely long lecture about Celestian philosophy, astronomy, and magic theory. At the end of the lecture, the preceptor produces a small metal token for you, shiny. The preceptor speaks at length about the creation of devices with magical properties. When it is finished lecturing you, the preceptor produces a small metal token for you. Good job. You fit the three-course completion tokens into slots on the security plinth.
Congratulations. Your evaluation was a success, and you have been deemed worthy to enter the Stellarium. If you wish to continue, proceed to the pedestal immediately outside the doors of the Stellarium in the Grand Plaza. I am the Archivist. I am unable. The species. Your assistance removing them from the premises would be appreciated. Thank you.
The pedestal appears to be missing a small section of metal, a key of some kind. Perhaps Thornton Lewis knows about it.
But Perhaps you could help me if you've got... It's my duty to chronicle the exploration. To that end, I need to learn all I can. They left teaching devices. Could you read the Celestian tomes of the Zodiac around the city and learn about them? Your help will be invaluable.
Alrighty, this looks like a good spot to stop. I'll see you guys in the next couple videos. I'm gonna go take a little nap. And then I'll probably do some more gameplay of Wizard101. Anyways, I'll see you guys next time.